I've really got my heart set on finding us a tasty Mark II Jaguar. The problem is the gulf between the cars that are available out there. There's some cars between £3,000 and £4,000, but they're absolute basket cases needing tons of work. And at the other end of the spectrum, there's cars for up to £25,000 that are completely restored. The problem I've got is trying to find a car in between the two, and they're extremely rare. Jaguar made over 90,000 Mark II, so you'd think there'd be a load out there to choose from. But this car is over 50 years old now, and its biggest problem has always been rust. But if you know where to look, you can sometimes turn up a gem. There's one car here that has caught my eye. What's done it for me is the colour. It's like a British racing green. It says it's had plenty of money spent on the engine, but it's the way that he said things like this. It's straight, ready to go, and she's on the button, ready to enjoy. And that does it for me. Plus the price, it's £8,000, and that's right at the sweet spot where I want to be. So, let's give him a call.
I got straight through to the owner, Andrew, and from the way he described the Jag, it was clear he knew what he was talking about.
Cheers then, bye-bye. Well, what a nice chap. And I've really got a clear idea about this car. It's half done. He just says the interior is very tatty, but I know you can get an interior for one of these. I definitely think this motor is worthy of a tank of fuel, so I'm going to go and see it. Now, it was a little bit chilly this morning, but the forecast says the sun is going to beat out. And in my book, that means it's perfect weather to go and have a look at a classic car. Because there's an old saying, never buy a car in the rain. And you know what? It's probably one of the best tips I could ever give you, because the rain can hide a multitude of sins. It can make a dull car look shiny. It can hide scrapes and dents. So, if the sun comes out, this could be the perfect time to go and buy a classic car. You, Andrew? Andrew, how you doing, mate?
Hello there, nice to meet you.
Spoke to you on the phone?
You did, yes.
What a lovely looking car. Look at the character it's got.
That's lovely, yeah.
A little bit worrying, though, when you turn up and see the bonnet open.
No, just checking the oil levels and stuff. Yeah, no, nothing wrong with it at all. It's had some work done on the engine, quite a bit of work. It's got E-type straight bolt heads. The SU carburetor's 2-inch larger, straight through exhaust. So it sounds gorgeous and it goes lovely.
Can I hear it?
Of course you can, yes.
Fantastic. I mean, it looks stunning, doesn't it, that engine? That's exactly what you want to see when you turn up to come and look at a motor. Very good. Give it a rev. Oh, yeah. One more. See, that is brilliant. Well, I've got no complaints about that, I'll tell you what. And the bodywork is so straight on this car, it's lovely. I love the flanks, very good. Any problems that you can think of?
No, structurally sound, very sound and dry and tight under there. My garage did pick up, there is a small hole, but it's not structural, so there's nothing to worry about.
I'll tell you what, it looks really good under there. Really good.
Yes, it's good.
Nice car. Right, well, inside, Andrew, it's looking a bit worse for wear, isn't it? Look at the seats, blimey. They've seen some use over the years. And the dashboard, well, that's a bit threadbare as well.
Seen the sun.
Yeah, the sun has got to that. This is going to need a complete interior.
Yeah, it probably will do, yes. But all the gauges work fine. They're all original Smith's gauges.
Lovely. It is a shame because it's going to need plenty of dough spent on the inside, and it doesn't match the exterior, which is lovely. I mean, it's rust-free, the bodywork straight, but that interior really lets it down.
But in its favour, it's a lot of money spent on things you can't see underneath. New disc brakes all round, uprated suspension for the handling. Take it for a drive and see what you think.
Right, time to put it to the test. Well, if I had to pick my top three British classics, then the Jaguar Mark II would definitely be amongst them. The stunning lines on the big cat are instantly recognisable, and the sounds coming from that 3.8 litre that produces 220 brake horsepower is intoxicating. Well, this old Jag has had plenty of performance modifications, and I'll tell you what, whoever done the work knew what they were doing, because back in the day, these Jaguars were favourites of bank robbers. They used to use them as their getaway cars. 0-60 comes up in around 8.5 seconds. Very quick indeed. But this one, well, whoa, it's a lot quicker. It feels incredibly peppy, and it's got a cracking throttle response. But it's no good
having all that performance if you haven't got good anchors. So let's see if they're up to the job. Ready? Nearly took my eyes out of my socket. They're fantastic, aren't they? They inspire real confidence. Oh, now there is a problem with this gearbox. It's done that a couple of times. It makes an horrible noise. I reckon it's related to the clutch pedal because it feels very, very spongy. Also, I've noticed that wherever I go, I'm leaving a cloud of smoke behind me. It's to be expected out of a car of this age, but it's not good. So far, things are mounting up on this motor. So what am I gonna do? Well, this car is a bit like a house. You know, when you're selling a house, you do the important things like the kitchen and the bathroom. That way people wanna buy it. And it's the same with this old Jaguar. The important stuff has been done. It's a great car, but I don't think it's worth £8,000. So I've got a figure in my head. I'm gonna go back and chip him and let's see how I get on. Well, I've got to tell you, that makes a fantastic noise, that
car. It's lovely, isn't it?
Absolutely, thoroughly enjoyed that getting down the road, yeah. But it has got its problems, so it is going to need some money spent on it. So with that in mind, you wanted how much? £8,000?
£8,000, yes.
It's just too much money for it, to be honest with you.
Make me an offer.
I'll tell you what, I'll give you £6,000 for it.
No, I wouldn't take six.
What would you take for it?
£7,000.
No, come on, I'll tell you what, I'll give you £6,500 for it, and that is a fair shout.
I couldn't do it for that. I mean, I've dropped from £8,000.
66.
No,
£67.
No, a little bit more.
This would be my last and final offer. If you don't take it, I'm out of here. £6,800. Hold out your hand. Come on.
Go on then.
Yes, I just bought myself a Mark II Jag.
Click here to subscribe.